Suzanne Arena, 88 Lakeland Road, Cranston. First of all, one of the things that I've heard tonight, and I've been coming to these meetings talking about my opinion and the resolution, which I was very happy to see that initially was put out. I'm not happy with the one that's changed and put in as well. I wanted to say I don't feel like you're supporting, the council doesn't support our school committee. And what I mean by that is Council President Ruggieri and a member of Colhane very articulately said that this has been going on a long time. They've been discussing this for a long time. I would think that they collaborate and talk to you and say that these are some of the things as a city that we're concerned about in our schools. So I don't know, I mean, it sounded like she was saying that this is something you've known about for years that they've been talking about, which I imagine is why you put this in. So I'm really baffled why we haven't done anything, we haven't moved this further. I have to say, my 14-year-old daughter, who has used guns, she knows how to take them apart, she knows that people kill with guns. Guns don't do the killing. I don't feel comfortable having my daughter in a school with people who have come in with a concealed weapon. And she's agreed with me that she doesn't feel comfortable, but she does feel comfortable having an armed police officer there. There's different perspectives. Some of these kids are younger, some are older, you know, from some of the people that I've been hearing. She feels more secure. I come from Boston, and in Boston, we have the poor areas. They've had metal detectors in schools for years. You go to the airport, it says the other gentleman said, they're all over the place. They're not that scary. So, you know, it's a perception of parents. We don't want to think that we have to have metal detectors there, but we've progressed, unfortunately. I don't think that we should have guns that have magazines that spray and take people out. I don't think that citizens should have them. But I just wanted to add one more comment is the decision about making having teachers have guns really bothers me. Police officers are trained to make split-second decisions, and they have to do it very quickly. They don't shoot their guns all the time, no, but I haven't seen any studies that say not having a police officer who's armed in a school proves that the kids are healthier and happier. Where are the studies to prove one way or the other? There isn't. But I can tell you that right now I would feel more comfortable knowing that my daughter or my son is at a school, or these children are at a school with an armed police officer who's been trained. These teachers have enough stress on their plate. I don't want them to feel that they have to do something like this. That's not what they're there for. I don't support anything like that, and that really bothers me that we would even consider something like that after the union president was talking about. And the last thing I'd like to say, the universal background checks. I mean, I think that we need to really be supportive. We should have had all this done a lot sooner. You know, we now have it going before the State House that there is some legislation finally being put in. Why do we have to wait for another city or town or for other legislation by someone else to be put in before we decide that, hey, let's support that, let's do our own? Why should we have to wait? Let's be the leaders. I'm a leader, I don't follow what everyone else says. So I really need to ask you to start looking at things when it's been on your plate for 2 years, I understand. I've only come into this a few months ago. We cannot wait. So let's maybe take the week, maybe by the end of the week. I think tomorrow's a little too premature. You want to get some sleep tonight. But I would ask that you not do a study commission or any kind of more studying and just putting it off. We don't want any more delays. Let's just sit around. I like the idea of having maybe a person from the school committee or the police, somebody from each department, the ACLU, whoever it is, NRA. Have us all sit down. A good negotiation is where everyone is not happy. I learned that through going divorce, when I was going through a divorce. You walk away and you have to make concessions, so everybody has to come to the table. That's all I have to say. Thank you.